You have arrived at the Chronoscope excavation site. Nell Gann is here somewhere, but can this place truly help her find her brother, or is she being deceived? Nell Gann smiles at you and turns to speak to the others. Professor Tremus gleefully turns to the nightmarish Mind Flayer. Keratrix, begin channeling Nell Gann's thoughts into the Chronoscope. Now, Miss Nell, this is very important. Think back to the last time you saw your brother.
Yes, that was in Stormreach. He was performing at his favorite spot by the Pawn Exchange, the day the Devil Army attacked. The devils overwhelmed us. People were panicking, trying to flee. And I lost sight of Nat. Oh, Nat, where did you go?
Nell and her companions vanished into a portal. Before you can follow, a green creature appears out of nowhere and sneers,
"All right, boys. Tremus's orders are to kill the squid face and anyone else left here."
With a blood-curdling scream, the last of Basdor's crew is dispatched. It appears Keratrix survived their attack. The Mind Flayer struggles to its feet. Is this the Stormreach marketplace? You hear the sounds of pillage and slaughter. A mystical doorway floats against the east wall of the tavern. Whoever created it may be powerful enough. Down below you is the marketplace, now a war zone in the midst of a devil invasion. At the center is a huge red tent, but it is not the tent you remember. Something strange is happening there. There are Abishai in here, but strangely, they do not attack. One of them sneers at you. That's Nat Gann behind the barrier. The devils appear to be interrogating him about something. The evil Tremus begins laying down his demands for Nel Gann's life.
You will go to the bank of Kondarik, to their Lord's March branch just next door. There you must acquire the key to the Gann's deposit box. I don't care what you have to do to get it. Bring the key back to me, and Nel Gann might, just might, live to grow into a dirty old woman. Just one more thing. You might run into a muscle-brained devil named Bloodplate. He's the aggressive type. Good luck, fools.
High atop a platform in the bank lobby, tiefling armorers nail metal plates directly onto a huge devil. It sees you and bellows,
"This bank is closed! Leave or your lives will be withdrawn!" Placements!
Thank you. I'll need replacements!
Maggots, the mighty blood plate slumps to the floor. Before its death, the fiend chokes out one. You have the deposit box key. Now, to return to the Phoenix Tavern and trade it for Nelgan's life. Primus eagerly takes the key and unlocks the deposit box.
At last I have it! The weapon that I travel back in time for! The sliver of time! Now, to keep my bargain, I shall return Nelgan to you as a dying old woman!
Ah, that's better. Now that I have stolen her youth for myself, I'm headed for the market tent, where I shall kill General Sulamadis with the sliver of time and become the new leader of the Devil Army. Clinging to the last threads of life, Nell wheezes out.
My only hope is the 12. Leave me here and bring back help. Go, quickly, while I can still stay awake.
Whatever the devils are doing in the market tent is... The sliver of time must be destroyed in order to save Nell, but it's somewhere in the market tent. Vahir has opened up a secret way for you to get there through the steam tunnels. Only hours ago, Devil Legions moved through the steam tunnels in an attempt to flank the 12. At least some of them are still here. You see a grotesque Orthon captain below, sporting a large repeating crossbow on his arm.
Oh, my God.
this sewer should be the portal to the market tent. Tremus is attempting to summon the Devil General to this tent, but when he sees you, Tremus stops his incantations and fumes,
"It's you again! What does it take to make you give up? My Abishai minions, come, destroy the mortal pests!"
Thank you. Thank you.
combined scream of five voices, the Abishai perish in a swirl of power. At almost the same moment, you become aware of something new and powerful arriving in the tent. A gigantic devil now stands next to Trinus. It stares disdainfully down at him and bellows,
"Why do you summon me, Tiefling? Are you so eager to die?"
"You're the one who will die when I use the sliver of time to drain your youth!" The sliver of time shattered? How?
"Idiotic Tiefling, you cannot steal youth from one who is immortal."
"No mercy, my Lord Sulamanis."
"I think I shall take you back to Shelrath and have you put to the question."
With Sulamadi's departure, the tent begins fluttering with a massive impulse of infernal energy. It may not be prudent to remain here much longer. The devil magics around the market tent have finally reached their peak. Whatever they are trying to do, it is happening now.